We won't care. The trees won't care.
This is outside.
What the hell am I gonna duct tape on?
That leg.
Yeah, don't hold on to the leg, then it'll break. So anything else in the. Well, maybe you can take a look. Okay, we have rolled it down. Okay, so. It's okay. So we may have to lift up a little bit on the. Okay, so lift up a little bit. Good? Okay, now, stop. So now, we want the piano under this. Probably, I think even on this side would be fine. So what I think I'll do is move this board.
We're not going to do it here.
Now let's just rotate the dolly so that the piano is
facing
keyboard's facing me.
Oh.
So yeah. So let's see if we can put it on the board.
Make sure the dolly doesn't go off.
Pull it towards you. Pull it towards you.
Yeah. Okay. Okay. You're almost off.
Bad race.
Okay. All right. I think we can twist this.
There you go. You got it.
Okay. Now. What we're going to do is get two people on each, or one person on each side.
Well, the legs have to be on the board.
Oh, right. So let's push back a little bit.
Yep.
That's okay, good. We're on the board. Okay, then we're going to just lift the piano straight up, and Malcolm will take the dolly out.
Okay.
3, 2, 1, go.
Okay, okay. Dolly's out.
Down.
Yay!
Yeah,
well, that's
how you move the piano in that wood.
We're ferns. We need to decorate around this. We're ferns.
It's good right. to know. I mean,
now. Let's hope that the Automillers made it, because they have the bench.
Oh, I see.
We're in this amazing place called the Elliott State Forest. I'm sure thousands of years ago it has many, many other spirits and names to it, and that's why it is so important that we save this piece of our wonderful coastal forest area, temperate rainforest. So I've been working on this issue, the Elliott State Forest. My name's Twyla Jacobson out of Eugene with Sierra Club and some other folks. And I was at a meeting in Salem with environmental groups, and the issues get very politicized, as we all know, and people take stands. And it's very left brain, kind of, how are we going to strategize and make something happen? And I just didn't, I felt like that we were going to lose if we kept on that kind of strategy. And so I was at home and I was watching Oregon Artbeat, and they did a segment that Darrell Grant was in with his, on the territory music and playing and speaking. And I thought, wow, you know, there's a great jazz musician. I really want to make sure I try to see him if I'm ever in Portland, or, you know, watch for him. And then I read some of his words on his website, and I realized that, you know, maybe he'd be interested in knowing about this issue. Maybe he would like to do something to help express the heart of the issue here through his music. And so I sent an email and just asking, you know, saying, you know, I was hoping that you might be interested in looking at the Elliott State Forest issue and think about how musicians and artists can bring this more to the public, this issue. It's not just an environmentalist issue, it's not just a timber industry issue, it's a community, but also it's life. You know, the heart of this place is the coho salmon and the streams and the marble murrelet. Without this place, they aren't going to exist. And we need them. So he got back to me about a week or so later, saying, well, he was thinking on it. And he hadn't really thought about how, you know, to get directly involved in this. And then he reached out to his community of artists, friends, on a blog and on his website, and they started a discussion, and it was very interesting. And he decided to, yes, let's do this. Let's bring music out into the forest and invite people to come, invite musicians and other interested people to have music inspired by this place come performed here in the Elliott State Forest. So here we are today, April 1st, 2017, a caravan of about a dozen cars or more and around 40 to 50 people. We're having lunch, we're sitting around talking, and we're soon going to have some beautiful music. And in the meantime, there's beautiful music here already, so it's an inspiration for all of us. Thank you.
Luciana Peronia. I guess this is a good time to officially say thank you to everyone who came, everyone who encouraged myself and everyone else to that this was a reasonable thing to do, which it's not. But I'm just so glad that we could all come out and celebrate the forest. I wanted to start by reading, this is an invocation that is from my territory CD, which I did, you know, 4 or 5 years ago now, but it's called Welcome to the Territory. The territory is ground, water, sky, and everything in between. It is what was here before you came and what will be here after you are gone. It is the bones, the sweat, the blood, the dreams, the blessings, the harvests, the floods, the tears, the rocks, the roots, the broken branches, fallen leaves, and forgotten paths. It's the songs of bug, bird, blizzard, wagon wheel, salmon, elk, beaver, and berry. It is the bank of the creek, the bed of the river, the stump in the ground, and the memory of the elders. The territory is the whole story, told and untold.
It's too natural for my liking. Thank you.
woods.
I parked the out-thrusting branches and come in beneath the blessed and blessing trees. Though I am silent, there is singing around me. Though I am dark, there is vision around me. Though I am heavy, though I am heavy, there is flight around me. Rusting branches and come in beneath the blessed and blessing trees. Though I am silent, there is singing around me. Though I am dark, there is vision around me. Though I am heavy, there is flight around me. Woods.
Pointiana, Song of the Tree.
And to call the chickadee, you can go. Birds sings to you the weariness I
and exchange graceful lilting melodies with a sightless bird.
Thank you.
then why can't it be everlasting? Like the sun that always shines, like the poets in this rhyme, like the galaxies in time. If it's special, then with it, why aren't we as careful as making sure we dress in style, posing pictures with a smile, keeping danger from the child? He holds the key to every heart throughout on seashores, there are shells, like the time that always tells. It holds the key to every heart throughout the universe. It fills you up. And it quenches every thirst. So, if it's magic, why can't we make it everlasting? Like the lifetime of the sun.
Now this story is about what happens out in the woods, right down on the forest floor, in fact, where you're going to meet three monks and hundreds of mushrooms. You see, we're closer to mushrooms than you might think. They inhale oxygen and exhale carbon dioxide just like you. They make vitamin D, too, and the mycelium out of which they grow is a sentient being, a neurological membrane, and the mushrooms are their fruit. Largest organism in the world is a mycelium mass spreading 2,200 acres, and those membranes are out there in the forest, waiting for your step. Now that's where the monks come in, out in the forest, where I was hiking near Mount Hood one day and came across three of them. That's right, monks, real monks with orange robes, sandals, coolie hats, and walking sticks, monks with backpacks,
hiking the Pacific Crest Trail. Moving fast, too, because I never caught up to them again. But I knew they'd pass that way, because just like the legend says, wherever a monk steps in the woods, a mushroom springs up. It's true. And all along the trail that day, I saw hundreds of coral mushrooms pushing up through the duff and almost glowing in the forest light. Now you probably know that fungi are responsible for all our soil. And there's a fungus that prevents flu and smallpox. Other mushrooms will rid your house of termites and turn a diesel-soaked pile of dirt into a mound of good soil in just weeks. Sentient beings waiting for you. The mushrooms will rise to meet your step as a man rises to his fate. They're the body of the planet offering you salvation. So the next time you're out in the woods and come across some shrooms, don't kick them over. Get down on your knees beside them and feel the pressure drop and the pains ease. They're like the monks whose first vow is to free all living beings. Just picture it. The mycelium out there waiting for just the right conditions for their fruits to meet your step. And on the out day, they're growing. Spores drop, single cells become strings, strings, chains, chains, networks, then entire neurological membranes. And like the monks, they're ready to free us, ready to free the planet from the damage we've left in our wake. Mushrooms, out there waiting, just for you. Yes. Thank you very much.
Perfect.
Put your tie, tie. Gimme ra. Go run it, go home on it. Go hey, nay, hey, nay. No way. Pepper says no way. I think it's no why. He's probably right.
Thank you.
Who played, and I just thought it would be really nice for us to share a moment together. Cole, are you still here? Yeah, cool.
Yes, he had another,
yeah, so,
he had another
and
gig.
Len, cool.
Cole had a gig up in Moon Lake.
Cool. Somebody take a picture of us.
Outdoor wedding gig.
Cool. Yes, and we will. Thank you. Cool.
So thank you all.